हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. दिस इज द लेक्चर नंबर 8, द फर्स्ट चैप्टर. लेक्चर नंबर 8, द स्टडी वी आर डिस्कस लॉ ऑफ डेफिनेट प्रोपोर्शन. बेस्ड ऑन द लॉ ऑफ डेफिनेट प्रोपोर्शन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट सम न्यूमेरिकल्स, न्यूमेरिकल एग्जाम्पल. लेट्स सी सम एग्जाम्पल्स. ए प्योर सैंपल ऑफ सोडियम फ्लोराइड NaF कंटेन 35 ग्राम ऑफ सोडियम. How many gram of fluorine are present in the sample? A pure sample of sodium fluoride contain 35 gram of sodium. How many gram of fluorine are present in the sample? So, sodium fluoride, students. Sodium fluoride, 23 gram of sodium. It means this is the sodium atomic mass. 23 gram. The 1 mole of sodium is 23 gram. Which is bond with 19 gram of fluorine. This is the atomic mass of fluorine. Atomic mass of fluorine. Right, students? When you count the sodium fluoride atomic mass, I will show you. Sodium 1, atomic mass 23. Fluorine 1, atomic mass 19, students. Right? Understood? This is the sodium atomic mass, fluoride atomic mass. So that's why I am using 23 gram of sodium bond with 19 gram of fluorine. 23 gram of sodium bond with 19 gram of fluorine. Then if 35 gram of sodium, how many gram of fluorine are present in the sample? If 35 gram of sodium is there in a compound which contain 35 gram of sodium, then how many gram of fluorine must be present here? Let's see. 23 gram of sodium bond with 19 gram of fluorine. It means 35 gram of sodium, 35 gram of sodium bond with how many gram of fluorine atoms? Yes, students. Then 35 into 19 cross multiply divided by 23. Yes, students. Then we got 19 gram of fluorine here. This is 35 gram of sodium. This is 23 gram of sodium. 23 gram of sodium. 35 gram of sodium. Sodium get cancelled, then it forms the 28.9 gram of fluorine atoms. 28.9 gram of fluorines. Right, students? Okay, let's see next example. If there are 42 gram of hydrogen in a sample of pure methane CH4. If 42 gram of hydrogen in a sample, pure methane CH4, how many gram of carbon are present here? How many gram of carbon present? 42 gram of hydrogens present in methane. Then how many gram of carbon is present? Let's see. CH4. Let's see, CH4. In this CH4, one carbon is there, that is 12 gram. Plus 4 hydrogen is there, that is 1 gram. It means that is total 4 gram of hydrogen bond with 12 gram of carbon here. So can we write here 4 gram of hydrogen bond with 12 gram of carbon, right? So this is called as a 4 gram bond with 12 gram of carbon. 4 gram of hydrogen bond with 12 gram of carbon. So 4 gram of hydrogen bond with 12 gram of carbon, 42 gram of hydrogen bond with how many gram of carbon atoms? 42 into 12 divided by 4, then we got the 404 gram of carbon. Students, this is the second examples. So in this method, this both example which belongs to law of definite proportion. It means the fixed mass, they are fixed masses. If 4 gram bonded with the 12 gram of hydrogen, the methane in which the carbon and hydrogen are ratio is same, then constant mass of 4 gram of hydrogen react with the constant mass of carbon, 12 grams. Right. Similarly, if you are using the 42 gram, then how many constant masses of carbon is required here? The constant mass of carbon required here, that is 405 gram. 405 gram of carbons are required to bond the 42 gram of hydrogens. Yes, students. Okay, students. Let's do one more example. What is the percentage composition of sodium chloride? What is the percentage composition of sodium chloride? It means the sodium chloride means, students, the NaCl. This means the sodium chlorides. Sodium chloride. In this sodium chloride, what is the percentage of sodium? And what is the percentage of chlorine? Consider the NaCl is 100%. NaCl combined to form a single compound, which is we are considered as 100%. Which is we are considered as 100%. So 100%. In which, what is the percentage of sodium? And what is the percentage of chlorine atoms? What is the percentage of sodium? What is the percentage of chlorine? Let's see. What is the percentage of composition of sodium chloride? Percentage composition. The molecular mass of NaCl, 1 sodium atomic mass 23 plus 1 chlorine atomic mass 35.5 gram. So total molecular mass of NaCl is 58.5 gram. Total molecular mass of NaCl is 58.5 gram. Yes, students, let's see. Percentage of sodium is equal to atomic mass of sodium, the formula, students, the formula, atomic mass of sodium by molecular mass of sodium, sodium chloride, NaCl. Percentage of sodium means we want to calculate the NaCl we are considered as 100%. NaCl we are considered as 100%. In this 100%, what is the percentage of sodium? Percentage of sodium, molecular mass of sodium chloride. So we are using atomic mass of sodium chloride, right? Molecular mass of sodium chloride, atomic mass of sodium by molecular mass of sodium chloride into 100. So atomic mass of sodium is 23, molecular mass of sodium chloride is 58.5 gram. 23 by 58.5 gram into 100, then we got the sodium percentage is 39.9 gram. 9% is 39.3%. Restaurants, 39.3%. Similarly, we are using, students, percentage of chlorine. Atomic mass of chlorine. This is a chlorine atomic mass, students. This atomic mass of chlorine we are using here. Atomic mass of chlorine, that is 35.5. Divided by molecular mass of NaCl, that is 58.5 gram. Molecular mass of NaCl is 58.5 gram into 100, the 60.7. This is the percentage of chlorine. Questions. So percentage, the percentage can be depend upon the how many number of atoms are present into their atomic mass. Here we are using only one atomic mass of sodium, one atomic mass of chlorine, because only one atoms are present in these compositions, right? If number of atoms are higher, then you had to use number of atoms into atomic mass. Number of atoms into atomic mass. Right, students? Let's see. We will see one example. So then we calculate. If we calculate the sodium percentage, 39.3. Chlorine percentage, 60.7. Then we got the 0.00. That is 100%. So it means this formula, this example, which is belongs to the law of constant compositions. Questions. Let's see, students, one more example. 1 mole of vanadium pentoxide contain 5 moles of oxygen atom. 1 mole of vanadium pentoxide contain 5 moles of oxygen atom, as it is clear from its formula V2O5. What is the percentage of oxygen by weight in V2O5? What is the percentage of oxygen by weight in V2O5? Atomic weight of vanadium, V stand for vanadium, students. V stand for वेनेडियम, एटॉमिक वेट ऑफ वेनेडियम इज 50.9 ग्राम पर मोल. एटॉमिक वेट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन, राइट, एटॉमिक वेट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन यू मे राइट हियर द एटॉमिक वेट, एटॉमिक वेट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन, ओ फॉर ऑक्सीजन स्टूडेंट्स, और यू वेट ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इज 16 ग्राम, यू आर यूजिंग वन एटम्स, 16 ग्राम पर मोल. सो मॉलिक्यूलर मास ऑफ वेनेडियम पेंटोक्साइड, द एटॉमिक मास ऑलरेडी मेंशनड हियर, वेनेडियम एटॉमिक मास 50.9 ग्राम, वेनेडियम टू टाइम्स, एटॉमिक मास इज 50.9 ग्राम, ऑक्सीजन फाइव टाइम्स 16 ग्राम. Then you multiplied, then you got the molecular mass of vanadium pentoxide is molecular mass of vanadium pentoxide is 181.88 gram per mole. This is the atomic mass of vanadium pentoxide. Questions. Next, percentage of oxygen. We have to calculate the percentage of oxygen by weight in vanadium pentoxide. So mass of oxygen by total molecular mass of vanadium pentoxide, percentage of oxygen is equal to mass of oxygen by total molecular mass of vanadium pentoxide into 100, 5 into 16, vanadium 5 moles, 5 atom, 5 oxygen atom, 16 gram divided by 181.8 gram into 100, that is 44.0. The percentage of oxygen is 54.0 gram. Okay, students. Okay, students. Let's see the limitations of the law of definite proportions. So, this limitations which has explained that the law of definite proportion is incorrect based on these two points. Right. Let's see the first point. This law is not applicable for isotopes of an element because element have same atomic number but different atomic mass. This law is not applicable for the isotopes of an element at that time after the invention of the isotopes of element. When the Joseph Prost explained this law, after he explaining the some isotopes of element invented. When isotopes of elements was invented, this law is not applicable for the isotopes of element because the element have a same atomic number but different atomic mass. Right. So the same elements are there but their atomic mass is different here. So that's why these values are cannot be considered as a law of definite proportions at that time. That's why this law considered as a fail because of the two element which having the different their atomic mass. If atomic mass is different, mean their proportion also different. The proportion is not constant. The proportion the different means constant when the proportion is not constant here. Proportion is not constant. So that's why this law becomes fail. Questions. Let's see the second law. This law is not true for some compound in which elements combine together in the same proportion. Elements are combined with each other together same proportion but gives different compounds. Elements are combined with each other but gives same proportion, same compound, which the elements are combined together. After combining, they are giving combined together in the same proportion. The carbon number of carbon, number of hydrogen, number of oxygen are remain same, but they give the different compounds. If they give different compound means the law is not the value is not where the law is not true. Right. Okay, example dimethyl ether डाइमिथाइल ईथर स्टूडेंट, दिस इज द डाइमिथाइल ईथर, डाइमिथाइल टू टाइम्स मिथाइल दैट इज डाइमिथाइल ईथर. सो कार्बन हाइड्रोजन ऑक्सीजन. सो कार्बन रेशियो, कार्बन एटॉमिक मास 24, टू कार्बन आर देयर एटॉमिक मास 24, हाइड्रोजन 6, 6, 3, 3, 6 हाइड्रोजन, ऑक्सीजन 1, 16. सो रेशियो इज, द रेशियो इज 2, 3, 8, राइट. ईथर अल्कोहल कार्बन 2, 24 एटॉमिक मास, हाइड्रोजन 5, 5 + 1, 6, 6 हाइड्रोजन एंड द ऑक्सीजन, अगेन दिस ऑल्सो द 2, अगेन द 12, 3, 8, द रेशियो इज 3. सो हियर द रेशियो सेम बट कंपाउंड इज डिफरेंट. द रेशियो आर सेम, कंपाउंड इज डिफरेंट. हियर रेशियो मस्ट बी डिफरेंट हियर बिकॉज ऑफ डिफरेंट ऑफ एटॉमिक मास. सो दैट्स व्हाई दिस, because of the invention of this, because of the invention of the invention of the isotopes and the invention of the two different compounds, this law considered as a fail. Right, students?